So we're back here on the second part of the Uber Speed Hot Pursuit Let's Play. Second part of the Uber Speed Let's Play, as I said, we're continuing with preview cars and really crawling a hole under the series, pretty much. It's easy to play this game when you know all the levels from 10 years ago, but that's just me. So, Rapid Response, Astomar 177. Why is it called that? There's only 77 of them. $1.2 million car, a little bit depreciated, holds value.
A lot more practical than the new stuff that they make.
See how that Valkyrie stuff plays out, but this is a classic Grand Tour style sports car with power 7 years ahead of its time before the Ferrari F12 came out. The only letdown's that single clutch with the automatic. Here we haul ass. We grab Nas, swing around the turns, ride the oncoming, and the boost builds up fast in the car that does 220 miles an hour so easily. I mean, we're flying. Adjusting the steering angle allows you to dodge traffic while it's sliding. Coming out of exits is probably the more difficult part, getting the thing straight, and sometimes you might have to still steer it while sliding in order to avoid oncoming traffic. Here we gotta make it without hitting any more barriers, because I'm sick of doing that already. It tightens up at the end. You think you feel good, but you have that tight S's at the end. Nice kinks. And then you can nail it out of there back to the coastal highway. Great drive, quick event. But you fly to escape super fast if you know where to be. The 350Z for me was a bit sketchy on this one. I probably should have chose a different car. It's a little slower, but this one's really sensitive. I don't know if it's the short wheelbase or the way they have it set up, but it's pretty sketchy to slide in, overdo it, and it's a bit twitchy. It's not a perfect car, but it's fast in a straight line, and that's the main thing that counts on it that I'm just trying to go for.
Central to all units, officers require assistance on Boulder Road. All units respond, this is an emergency situation.
Taking the shortcuts where we can right there. But the sensitivity of the car does get excessive when I'm trying to play with the driver. The car does become a bit of a handful. One of the harder cars to drive in the game, I will say that. Try to get halfway through the game, and then we do some multiplayer races, try to get as many cars as possible in the shortest period of time. But it seems to be going pretty smooth as it is, because I did take out a big chunk of them, like a quarter way there, as is with the footage that you have seen here so far. Traffic messes you up. Uphill messes you up, especially in a slower car, so you want to save the NAS for uphill if you can. Great downhill speed boat up there, doing 176, 10 miles an hour over the factory. This tunnel is pretty dicey coming out of it. I had to back off of it, which I didn't want to do, but I had to avoid the pickup truck and be careful. The car does lack a change of direction as well. I think that might be its plague, is just a lack of feedback. It does seem to go wherever it wants to go sometimes. There's a final shortcut that you gotta take in order to save time, otherwise you're not gonna make the cut. New stuff every level, you get new stuff. Main thing I'm going for is that old school 911 turbo, which you'll see later in this video, so you'll be able to see that car in action.
For this next mission, your interceptor vehicle has been fitted with a spike strip release mechanism. Activating the weapon will release the lethal spike strip from the rear of your car. Your vehicle can only carry a limited number of strips and will take time to recharge after each use, so only fire when you are confirmed a hit. Command out.
We're going old school with the crowd on this one. I say old school, it's only 10 years old, but it just goes by pretty fast when you think about it. I like these alternate screenshots that have the Porsche DLC cars in them. And the Lambo DLC cars, different screenshots that they have.
Officers in pursuit of a Subaru Impreza on South Face Drive. Suspect is left road, suspect off road, requesting assistance.
So we gotta catch this guy, and he constantly goes off-road. That's the selling, the catch to this, catch to this chase, that he'll always take a shortcut, so you know where he's gonna go, if you can cut him off. Unfortunately, I screw up right off the bat, so we're gonna fix that. But his downfall is that he keeps making dives for those shortcuts at the last possible second. It slows him down. It allows us to catch up. And with the big boost out of the cop cars, it should not be a problem. Just that it's hard to build boost in this round. I guess they make it progressively harder.
Officers in pursuit of a blue Subaru Impreza on South Face Drive. Suspect is left low, repeat. Left the road and is heading towards the construction tunnel.
The great crap, like, only in hot pursuit games can you drive this car. Big 4-speed. Way overrated and overpowered from reality, but I don't care, it's good. If Even though they're not fast cars, but they're built like tanks, pretty much. Reinforced frames, steel wheels, bigger brakes, shocks, everything that's unique to the cop car package for the Crown Vic. And the body on frame is way more rigid and cheaper to repair than these unibody cars. That's the main selling point with the older Crown Vics. But they're game ready with body on frame cars one by one to the point where I don't think there's any left.
Suspect is headed onto the South Bay Trail.
This was the last body on frame car, so the last cheap car to repair. Price is only going to go up because they put him out of production. Now we got him down to a sliver of red health, so now we got to catch him and dive bomb him. There you go, textbook.
Target has been apprehended, all units stand down.
I'm back on the off on the commentary because it's Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. It's the gameplay that you want to see. It's a new release for the career mode. I'll probably come back with commentary on the multiplayer side of it, which I hope to get a couple games in and do a couple of videos for the time being. But right now, you want to get the gameplay out, show the campaign. It's a pretty easy campaign. I think the first time I had this game, I'll go back a little bit. It'd be like a week. Or like 2 days or some ridiculous span of time, because you just, it's very addicting to play, you just get sucked into it, really. This arcade physics. Here's a unique event from the Porsche DLC, the GT2 RS Widowmaker Porsche at the time, early 2010s, late 2000s, the hottest Porsche on the market, the GT2, as always. Dangerous car. But fast as hell. You gotta love the sound effects too, the backfired exhaust, the nitrous, the revs. These flat 6s and V6s sound like V12s borderline because of how exaggerated they are, but I like it a lot. So anyway, I'll see you in the next video. Like, comment, subscribe for more content, be ready to see more on Hot Pursuit. I'm out. We'll be right back.
during the exercise, but you will be evaluated as if this was a live situation.
Thank you. Throughout its entire production run from 1975 to 1989, the Porsche 911 Turbo was the top-of-the-range model from Porsche. Making use of turbocharging technology, which Porsche had begun experimenting with.
To all units, officers require assistance on West Beach Freeway. This is a training exercise, but you will be evaluated as if this was a live situation.
We'll be right back.
Roger that. 1073 approved. Roblox units deploying directly ahead of you.
I've made contact. My vehicle has taken damage.
Roadblock has been passed. Roadblock has been passed. Suspect is still running.
Suspect has missed the spike strip. Suspect has missed the spike strip. Better luck next time. Over. Roadblock is deployed directly ahead of you.
Roadblock reporting 10 minutes. All units move in.
the cops in Seacrest County continue to increase their presence. To fight fire with fire, your car has been fitted with a police-spec EMP system. The EMP system fires a directed electromagnetic pulse from your car to a target vehicle. The system requires an active lock-on to correctly track the target. Once fired, you are required to keep the target car within range and line of sight for the tracking system to engage. If a cop is hit with the EMP, their patrol car will be damaged and temporarily disabled. Use the time wisely.
I'm gonna disable this car.